ruina.
Preston, Ed, Michael, and Paige, we're on our way to Dundee, Wisconsin, to meet the Koepke family. And up to about a year ago, this was a very happy family of six. It was Chris, Matt, and their four kids. The crazy thing is, this year, Matt was diagnosed with cancer. Him and his family made a tape asking us for our help. So guys, take a look at this tape. You'll see why we're here.
Don't give me no pop, no pop. Don't give me no tea, no tea. Just give me that milk. Moo, 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 moo. Wisconsin milk. Moo, 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 moo.
Wait.
Hey!
We're the Koepke family from Dundee, Wisconsin.
I'm Matt, the dad.
I'm Chris, the mom.
I'm Derek, I'm the oldest.
I'm Jaina, the second oldest.
I'm Mitch, third oldest.
I'm Johanna, the baby.
Matt and Chris were high school sweethearts. They've been married 22 years and have four children. This family doesn't have a lot of money, but what they do have is a lot of love for the town that they live in, for their family, and for their old farmhouse.
Our house was built in 1932 by my great-grandfather and his wife.
They didn't have any electric.
No electric, no
plumbing, no indoor plumbing.
The house is in really rough shape, but Chris and Matt have always wanted to renovate it and turn it into their dream home.
This is the dining room. This is where you're gonna see more of the ductwork exposed because the home did not have heat ducts running upstairs. We had to pull the ceiling apart and never finished vats.
We have a bat problem in the ceiling.
They're all over, you can mostly hear them over here, and Austin will be sleeping at night, it'll be like, and they'll scratch and we'll be like, oh my gosh, this is our bathroom, our one bathroom for six people. The walls in here are, there is insulation behind them that Matt put in, and then we covered them with boxes just until we got drywall in.
So Matt's other dream, restoring the town's 150-year-old mill. It's kind of a historic landmark in the town, and he really wanted to see it up and running. So he was working on this thing for a decade. Then, 6 months ago, something terrible happened, and it pretty much stopped all the renovation work. Matt was diagnosed with something called metastatic melanoma.
Unless cancer hits your family, you don't know what it's really like. It just feels surreal.
Some days are good, some days aren't so good, but it's still positive.
Matt went through radiation treatment, but his body didn't respond the way doctors thought it might. And the cancer got more aggressive and more aggressive.
Melanoma is one of the cancers that they have not found a cure for. And they're hoping someday soon they will, but at this point in time, there's no cure for Matt. It hit us hard because I don't think any of us were ready to see him go.
My dad's dream would be to see us living happily in a house that he knows is safe for us.
I know in his mind he doesn't want to leave us just here.
I called the family at the hospital, and I asked him to put the phone up to Matt's ear. And while he's lying in his hospital bed, I told him that we were coming to help out his family.
I'm good.
I just can't imagine getting a new home. I mean, it's just,
it's overwhelming.
Just 4 months after he was diagnosed, Matt Koepke died. I made a promise, and now it's time to fulfill that promise. So guys, can you help me do that?
Yes,
yeah,
definitely.
Bring it in here, people.
Okay.
This one's for Matt, okay?
Yeah.
One, two, three.
For Matt!
Come on, guys, let's go.
We wanted to get to this house and fulfill a promise that Ty made to Matt. But at the same time, it's only been 5 weeks since their dad died. I hope we're here at the right time.
Good morning, Koepke family! Chris, Derek, Jaina, Mitch, and Johanna! Come on out here! Yeah! What's happening?
Hey there, guys!
How are you?
Hi there!
Hi!
Hey there!
When they first walked out of that house, massive hugs. When they squeezed you, it was like a
like a thank God you guys are here.
Oh, I'm so excited to have you there.
I just want you guys to know that we're really, truly honored to be here.
I know Matt wanted to be here.
We're hoping that we can help a few things out this week. Matt had a kind of a dream to do that, right?
He did. He wanted to give us a good home. I know he's here with us. Dad's here.
Chris is probably under a lot of strain and a lot of worry and a lot of uncertainty, but she's handling it so well. She's a great example for kids.
So here's what's gonna happen this week. First of all, you guys are gonna take a much needed break. And then we're gonna start working on building you a house that I think Matt always really wanted for you guys. And while we do that, you guys are going on vacation. Would you like to know where you're going on vacation?
Yes.
Well, how does San Diego, California sound? So here's what needs to happen. We need to get you guys in the limo off to vacation, but first, show me the house, okay?
Okay.
The house that they're living in is in really bad shape. You've got a kitchen that, it's cool that it's that old, but what's not cool is the fact that it doesn't work like a regular kitchen. So this is the kitchen.
This is the kitchen. Everything's, you know, original.
Wow. And so what about this stove?
That garbage can's holding that door up.
Oh, really? Yeah. If I move this... Right. Okay, I see what you mean. We'll just put that right back there.
Yeah.
We're going into the dining room?
The dining room.
You've got some really nice pieces of furniture here.
Yeah.
So these are some antiques,
yeah, it's
huh?
one of his great aunt's dining room sets. The mirror and the buffet and the
mirror's
table.
Mirror's beautiful,
isn't
man.
Isn't it pretty? Yeah.
And these are all family photos.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Those were just taken about a month after Matt was diagnosed by a good friend of ours. She took us out to Lake Michigan one day. She said, this is for you. This is what I want to do for your family. And. Uh-huh. Yeah. And we have lots of good memories from that day, too. We did a lot of laughing that day.
You just can't believe that someone can be healthy and strong 6 months ago and then not even be here today. You just never know how much time you're going to have. So you have to make every moment you're here the best.
Oh, yeah. You guys find the design team. I'm going to talk with your mom for a minute, then we'll get you guys packed in the limo. Sound good?
Okay.
All right, cool.
Yep. All right.
All of these kids know without a doubt how Matt felt about them. They know that they were loved so much by their dad, and, you know, they're getting through it. It's hard, but they're getting through it.
How are you guys holding together so well?
At first, you know, it was like, oh, dad will come walking in the...
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
The back door someday,
yeah,
and...
Every time, like, you hear the truck go by, you always think dad's pulling in the driveway.
Yeah.
And I was like, jump up, and I was going, never mind.
It was really hard.
We couldn't get here before Matt died, but we're definitely taking over where he left off. And although we didn't get to meet him in person, it's never too late to take care of his family.
Sure, sweetheart, don't even worry about it.
This is our room, Matt's and mine, and it needs a lot of work.
So tell me about this photo. Wow.
Obviously, it's a few years back.
What a beautiful photo.
I look at it now and I'm thinking, it's kind of symbolic, you know, that... He's not in it. And now it's like we are now. Just me and the kids. Lots to think about. Matt would always say that, lots to think about, but nothing to worry about. That was one of the things he used to say a lot. So we'll have to live by that.
We don't need to spend so much time worrying about something as we do, just trying to think about how we can make it better. And that's what Matt really kind of focused on.
Well, you seem pretty attached to some of the things in this house.
Yeah.
And what I'm wondering is if for us to really kind of give you, I think, the house that Matt really wanted, this house might need to go. Are you okay with that?
We're okay with that. We'd be okay with this house not being here.
That's good to hear.
I think we would be.
This is just a decorative wheel, right? It never had...
They were planning on, as time goes on, they're planning on putting it...
Because that would be a great feature to add, just to have water dump into it and have it turning. The Dundee Mill is a historic site, and boy, how convenient to have the old mill right down the road from your house. It was Matt's wish that we restore the mill, which is a big part of his life. So I'm gonna redo that mill and make that part of his wish for his family come true. And for this place to actually come to fruition like your dad wants, we got to get a new turbine, right? Okay, get the turbine in, that's the real work. Cool.
Matt,
was a pretty healthy guy, right?
He was very healthy.
Was he worried about leading you with everything in your hands?
He didn't tell me he worried, because I think he thought if he told me, then I'd worry that he was worrying. He didn't want us to worry about him or silly things in life.
What are the things in life that are important?
Telling people you love them more often than what you do, because you just don't know when you're not going to have that person in your life anymore. He did say that he was going to miss us, though. Like Christmas and our daughter's wedding. Yeah. Things like that.
Do you remember the day when we called?
Yeah. We all start crying. He broke down. He knew at that point he wasn't going to live. But he was relieved and he was happy. And I think just a huge weight was lifted off of his shoulders, that we'd be okay.
Well, we made a promise that day. I'm so happy that we could fulfill that promise. Does that sound pretty good?
It does, thank you.
All right, well, give me a hug.
Thanks.
Chris lost the love of her life. She's lost her best friend. I'm sure the family would much rather just have their dad and their husband back. We can't do that. But what we can do is make his wish and his dream come true. Okay, so you guys ready for a little vacation?
Oh, yeah!
Pile in the limo.
Bye, Ty. Thank you.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
We're gonna be good.
Okay.
Have fun. Thank you.
Family, okay?
We will.
I'll see you guys in a week.
Fun. Bye, Ty.
You guys have a blast, all right?
Bye.
We'll see you in a week. Bye, guys.
Bye.
We told Matt that we'll come build a house for your family. I think he felt a sigh of relief knowing that he could go on to his next life and know that his family would be taken care of. So we made a promise to Matt, and this week we're gonna deliver on that.
Coming up next.
The excitement and the energy of this town is unbelievable.
Look how fast those things are moving.
Hurry, 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 hurry.
The house was within an hour of getting a roof, and there was nothing we could do.
We made a promise, and we want to deliver on that.
Get that turbine in there and get that mill operative again.
We love every one of you.
All of this is the result of a very, very good man and how one person can leave their mark on this world.
Justin and Larry from Monarch Homes and all their whole crew coming in. And it's almost like they had a smoke machine going because the wheels were smoking so much. I tell you what, with the energy that they brought in, the power that they brought in just by coming in like that, you knew that these guys had the right stuff to get what we needed done this week.
So, wow, you brought quite the crew.
We brought them all, a little bit more.
And you showed up in style.
You got it.
Tell me about it.
We better set the precedence for some speed. That's what we've got to do here.
I like the sound of that. Hey, so the designers, I'd like you to meet Justin and Larry. They're with Monarch Homes. They're going to help us build a house for this family this week, right?
Yeah! Yeah!
We're ready to embark on the impossible. Monarch Homes is a family. You're all family. And we're going to build this house for a family in need.
Guys, I can't thank you enough for all showing up this morning. You know, most everyone here has been gathered because someone has the faith that you're the best there is in your particular trade or industry, mainly with your hands. That's how homes are built, with your hands. But I'm gonna be asking something more of you. I need something from here, from your heart, to get this project done in the time and the quality that we need for this family. Are you guys with me for doing this?
Yeah!
Thing, man, this is gonna be an awesome day. This is the day I think Matt was looking forward to his whole life, and this family has no idea that you guys are here and what's about to happen. So what do you say we let them know?
Yeah. Yeah!
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It's nice and warm.
I know, she's warm.
This is cool.
Hello, Koepke family. Guys, I hope you're having a fantastic time on vacation. Well, today's a big day. It's the day we like to call demolition. And to do it, we brought in some friends. And they'd like to say hi. Say hi, everybody.
Holy cow.
Now, I know your house is pretty special to you because it's been in the Koepke family for a long time. In fact, I know Matt's great-grandfather actually built the house. But it's also old and it has lots of problems, and, well, Matt himself wanted to rebuild a whole new one for you guys. So before we actually take your house down, we're going to go in and save a few things because I know they mean a lot to you, not only on the inside, but also on the outside. So people, who's ready to save a little house? Let's do it!
Okay, fellas, the bigger the lens, the better.
We're saving windows. We're also saving doors,
which is pretty amazing as well.
It's all our doors.
And saving the flooring.
Save it all, people! Save it all! Now, it's time for that house to come down. On my mark, are you ready?
Yeah!
Guys, hit it!
Having a lot of people around when we bring the family home, but not on demo day, not on the day we take down the house. I literally saw like thousands of people lining the streets, cheering us on. They're on rooftops, you know. The excitement and the energy of this town is unbelievable.
There goes the mud room! Oh! Wow! Oh! Well, family, as you can see, your house has been through a lot today.
But here's the good news. We've saved a lot and we've gotten rid of a lot.
And hopefully by the end of the week, well, Matt's dream is going to come true, and you guys are going to have a beautiful house to live in. And let's hope it does, because right now, well, all you have is a front porch. Well, maybe not.
Next.
Hurry.
The rain is coming in sideways. The lightning's just blitzing across the sky.
Something tells me that tarp is not going to hold.
Yeah, let's get everybody inside, guys.
These are all the windows that we took from the old house, and I'm going to make like kind of a cool, funky art piece in Johanna's room.
Typically, I take a kid's room and I make it a crazy theme. Well, these aren't really kids. You know, Johanna's almost 16, Jana's 20 years old. So although I'm kind of going with a theme, it's more of a sophisticated theme.
I want each of these girls to have something from the old house in their room. So, cool wall art piece, I think it'll be good.
Right, that's the first cut of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, at least 20 odd cuts. So this is the beginning of our big doors for Michael's room, which is basically going to be Mum's bedroom going into the main living area.
My project this week is the two huge 8-foot-high, 7-foot-wide walnut doors for Mum's bedroom. Got me work cut out, but I'm looking forward to it.
Hey guys, you ready to do a little shopping?
Always.
Yeah, this should be fun.
We all headed to Sears, and we knew we had a lot to shop for. I had to take care of the two girls, Preston had to take care of the two boys, and Michael had to take care of shopping for the rest of the house.
Bedding.
I think every girl needs some candles.
Charles, where is bedding?
This is good. Ooh, perfect. So soft. Mmm.
How'd you do?
I took care of these girls. They're gonna love it.
This isn't the first time a turbine has had to go back in the mill.
The turbine has been broken for some time, and that was one of Matt's dreams. Get that turbine in there and get that mill operative again. So that's what we're gonna do.
Okay, that's looking good. Right there, that one.
Well, this is as far as we go.
All right.
I wanted to do something in memory of Matt, something in stone that we could kind of make a bench out of. We piled up in the truck, and we went down to this quarry.
I think this would be perfect. I mean, then we'll etch some words on it.
There's this one sentence you used to always say, there are a lot of things to think about, but nothing to worry about. So we had that inscribed in honor of Matt.
This is one of the last steps in making this wonderful bench, is sandblasting in this phrase we got. There's a lot of things to think about, but nothing to worry about. Matt Koepke. It looks beautiful. Nice work, John.
I'll keep at it.
Okay.
We just got word that we potentially have some very severe weather coming this way. We heard golf ball size hail, potentially 60 mile an hour winds. We're about an hour out from getting the house roofed, so we're trying to keep it as dry as possible and make sure we protect all the glass.
The National Weather Service has issued severe thunderstorm warning effective until 9 p.m.
He just looked at the radar. It's a red line, and it's coming straight for us.
Where? How far away?
I would guess 10 to 15 minutes before the bad stuff gets here.
Look how fast those things are moving.
These clouds roll in, and before the lads can even get the roof done, the rain is coming in sideways. The lightning's just like blitzing across the sky, and it's like a case of we have got to get down and inside now.
Hurry, 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 hurry.
Something tells me that tarp is not gonna hold.
How many guys are up there? You're the last guy in the roof?
The house was within an hour of getting a roof when we heard about the storm. And there was nothing we could do. It could not have come at a worse time.
Everybody inside, guys.
Inside.
Everybody inside.
Let's go, everyone in.
Let's go, everybody in the garage. Come on, guys.
We don't quit running the power tools till this goes through. Everything is sopping wet.
These guys were not letting the weather stop them. And we're all inside, and water's just dripping down everywhere. And you look around, guys are still hammering away, still working on the house, making sure that this house gets done.
Good news is the storm has passed. The bad news is look at all this water. There's water everywhere in this house. But hear that in the background? That's a good sign. You know, the hand tools, they never stopped, but the power tools, they had to go off. And now electricity is back, and we're up and running. Now we just need to get some vacuum in here and clean this mess up.
So I've been working on a little special project, man. This week it's all been about family. And sometimes it's tough to get the whole family together for one photo. But I tell you what, that's exactly what Chris did before Matt passed away. And she had a photo taken, and this is it. I know it means a lot to the family, so I had it blown up. And it's going in this room. I can't tell you what the room's gonna look like, but I can tell you this. This photograph is going in here.
Old doors to the house. That is cool.
Okay, slide it along 3 inches roughly, give or take.
Yeah.
Let me just look
at that. Hey guys. Kind of quiet in here, isn't it?
Silence is
I'm
golden.
Guessing that means you guys are done.
That means the home is ready for you. Here's the keys.
So does that mean we can move into furniture?
We can move it in.
Well, what do you say we make an empty house a full house?
Let's go.
Let's do it.
People have been helping us all week, and like I went outside to say, like, let's move in some furniture. There were hundreds of people out there cheering, ready to go. And obviously Matt was a very loved person.
Have fun tonight moving in the furniture.
Will do.
We'll be back tomorrow. We're gonna get some rest.
You deserve
it.
We're
gonna be here.
You guys are awesome. All right.
Hey,
you guys are fantastic. All right, you're leaving the same way you came in. Fantastic. Hey, get some rest, guys. We'll see you tomorrow. Woo! All right, let's move in some furniture.
I spent all week gathering up the best of the best for this family. Could not wait to get it in the house.
Dining room!
Kitchen!
Master bedroom, okay. That's easy, that's downstairs.
You got a table within a table. Okay, that's gonna go in a room inside a room. I'm thinking a closet, go with it.
Got it.
So the night before the family came home, I kind of gathered everybody up down by this new bench that we had made in honor of Matt. Mitch's choir was there, Matt's mom, his brother, and kind of had a memorial for Matt.
It takes a town like this who obviously loves a family and loves a guy who made an impact on so many people. And because of everyone's help, we came together and we made good on a promise. And it's really Matt's dream, and it's actually happened. I just want to say thank you, guys.
Well, if it wasn't for all of you, of course this wouldn't have happened. All of this is very, very nice. I'd rather have Matt back, but this is very nice. And this is gonna, I saw that. I remember him saying that. And it's just, that means so much to me. Thank you so much.
On behalf of the Koepke family and the Willis family, we thank you and everybody that came.
The words of the song that we're going to sing are the words that are on this bench right here.
So many things, so many things, so many things to think about, but nothing to worry about. So many things.
All of this is the result of a very, very good man. And how one person can leave their mark on this world. And if you don't believe that, look around.
Nothing to worry about.
Just ahead.
Amazes me. We get the kind of support that we get in a town that's as small as Dundee. I heard that there were 17,000 people here to bring the family home. And like, these people are excited. I mean, they're on top of their rooftops with their shirts off, with the family name like spelled, you know, like they're at a Packers game.
It was just crazy just seeing all the people that were there and all the volunteers and how hard they worked for just us. And it was just great. Loved it.
For me, I think for the design team and for a lot of people that volunteered, a lot of us didn't get to meet Matt. But this week, we all grew a little closer to him this week because he was loved not only by you guys, but this entire town. And as you can tell by the turnout, well, they love you guys as well, and they're just so glad that we could finally bring you guys home, because I'll tell you what, we've all been waiting for this exact moment. Well, guys, would you like to see what's behind that bus?
Yes.
Well, then you know what to say. You gotta say it with me, okay? Isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It's amazing.
And as you can see, Well, I think Matt would approve.
Oh, yes, he would.
I mean, I looked at that house and I was crying because I was so happy. And, you know, right away I looked up and, you know, thought of my dad. Just to know that he's up there looking at us and he knows we're okay and he knows that it's going to be a great place and he couldn't be happier.
Do you like the house?
Oh, yes!
We'll say hello to Larry and Justin from Monarch Homes. This guy's worked nonstop, 24/7. We'll give you guys a beautiful home.
Thank you!
Thank you.
You guys were away on a well-deserved vacation. The whole Monarch family, our building team, which is also part of our family, and this incredible community put a lot of love into this place. That makes it not just a house, it's a home. And I hope you guys have a lot of wonderful years of memories and growing in this place.
We will.
You deserve it.
We will. Awesome. Thank you.
You guys, nice. How about a hand for Monarch Home? Guys, nice job. Thank you, Monarch. So, Kepkes, are you ready to see the inside of your house?
Yeah.
Well, then follow me.
Good luck, gang.
Nice job, guys.
Well, when we opened the door to the house, it was just awesome. Like, everything was neat and pretty and all fancy and looked like something out of a magazine. It's really cool.
It looks so weird.
So, guys, what do you think?
I don't even know what to think.
I'm just so overwhelmed. It's beautiful. It's so perfect. Breathe.
Yeah, just breathe, man. Just breathe.
Oh, this is...
So you guys like it, right?
Oh, yes.
So check this out. You realize what you're standing on? This is your old floor. It's your old floor.
It's our floor.
Yeah, here's the cool thing. All throughout the house, you're going to find stuff just like this that we've taken from the old house, tried to bring it back in, and bring some of that history back into your new home.
The fact that Ty and the design team incorporated all those things from our home really tells me that they care. They wanted to make those special touches for us so that we'd remember our old home and the times we had with Matt.
And this was one of your old doors.
That's our door.
That's your door, exactly. That's
our front door.
That's your front door. Now it's
our
back door.
Now it's our back door.
Check it out. Brand new washer and dryer from Kenmore.
That is awesome.
She's just giggling, you know? She's like so excited. She's happy. It's great because it felt like once they went into the house, some of the sadness was over and it was time for joy. There's a lot more house to see. So Kepke family, go check out your house. Go check it out. Downstairs, everywhere, go check it out.
Oh, wow. Holy cow.
This my dear.
Oh, this is awesome. Oh, my gosh. Holy cow. Oh, that's the back door. Wow.
Old. That's our windows.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh.
Oh,
look at all this.
Wow.
Oh,
wow.
There's red car everywhere.
Oh.
No package up here.
Yeah.
Look at the pink wall. Look at that.
Oh, Jana, this is so you.
It's so pink.
Oh, I love it.
Up next.
Here it comes.
That brought tears to your eyes because you knew that that was something that was waiting to see happen.
We love every one of you.
If you would like to find out how you can help families like the Kepkes, please log on to www.abettercommunity.com.
We'll wait here. Why don't you go check out your master bedroom?
Okay.
I think you're gonna like it.
Oh my. Oh my goodness. Oh my.
I'm just speechless. I'm so overwhelmed by how many people cared enough to help our family.
So this next room I'm about to show you is basically my special project. I know that the last couple months have been pretty stressful on you guys. So why don't you go check out what I like to call your family room.
Oh. There are these huge pictures. Every time we look at those, you know, you're gonna think back to that day and just remember when he was there. You see his smile, and you know that he's smiling like that down on you. Everywhere you go.
There's Dad.
Yeah.
Mitch, you okay, buddy? So I'm sure you're pretty tight with your dad. What do you think he would think of this house?
It's just amazing.
We all loved that room that Ty did. And we'll be putting up plenty more pictures in there just to remember the good times that we had with Dad and as a whole family.
You guys like everything you've seen so far?
Oh, gosh.
Yes, 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 okay, yes, yes, oh, yes, yes.
You want to see your backyard?
Yes.
Follow me.
Okay.
Well, I know that this is a place down here that you guys spent some time just kind of reflecting on life. I know this is where he loved to see the water. Well, there's also a saying he said all the time that you told me when we talked, right? Remember the saying he said?
Yeah.
So we have that scribed. There's a lot of things to think about, but nothing to worry about.
That's so true. Oh.
They had carved into the stone one of Matt's sayings that he said ever since he'd been diagnosed with his cancer. There's lots of things to think about, but nothing to worry about. That bench in our backyard is my favorite.
Guys, you want to take a look at the mill?
Yeah. I do. Yeah.
Follow me.
Let's go.
Starting to clean it up a little.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my gosh.
They went inside the new flooring. They're checking out, like, all the new furniture that's been built, the old photos, the new photos. So it's a place where you can actually take tours, show kids the history of the mill.
There's a few people outside that like to say hi. You guys want to say hi?
Yeah.
That'd be cool.
Come on out. Come on out.
The mill is what Matt has been working on for 10 years. With his friends, and it's just so cool to see the entire community waiting at the mill.
Preston?
Yeah.
You got one more surprise for us,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, we do. I'm gonna fire up the wheel.
Oh,
guys, you're gonna wanna see this.
Move that wheel! Move that wheel! Move that wheel! Move
that wheel! That brought tears to your eyes because you knew that that was something Matt was waiting to see happen.
We are so happy and thankful to have friends and family and just a wonderful community like Dundee that have come and helped do what Matt wanted to do for us. And we love him and we miss him. We miss him.
The fact that Matt's not with us doesn't seem real. That still hasn't sunk in. We kind of just keep going on day to day, thinking that he'll suddenly pop up. knowing that he won't. But we have such a wonderful life ahead of us with that new home.
Thank you so much. We love every one of you. Thank you, you guys, too.
You've done so much for us.
This is what family and community is about. This is what America is about. And it gives you hope that if something ever goes wrong with you or your family, that there's people out there that'll help. And I think this town shows you what a town's all about.
I guess there's just one last thing to say. Welcome home, Koepke family. Welcome home.
Cheese. Let's go. Hurry up. This looks like it's not quite ready yet. What can I do to help? Hey, hurry up. We got a family to bring home. Good, but I don't think I can put it in the house like this.